Are we all here ready to fucking go? I asked you all a question!
As I reveal my giant monkey!
That's not as funny as you thought it was, boy!
God, I thought it meant penis!
I swear, the only thing I hate more than weaklings...
Hey! I'm speaking, soldier! Don't fucking speak unless you're smart to fucking burn! What we're gonna do is we're gonna fly over the burn!
The talk show at the end of the week.
Space is big.
Star Citizen.
It's really big.
Round table.
Hello? Is this thing on?
This thing on.
I think it is.
Are we live?
Gobble, gobble, gobble.
Does it work?
2954, everybody.
2954.
Are you really going to pretend we're like in Star Citizen? Come on. 2024, yes. Baby.
We are. That's the whole point.
2024. That was like 900 years ago. What are you talking about? That was like that stupid year that...
Look, I do not want to be around for 900 years.
America capitulated.
That just sounds... I don't want to be around for 900 years. It just doesn't seem like it's going to be a lot of fun.
I want to live forever.
Great movie. The Highlander.
What, who's the boss?
No, the Highlander.
Highlander.
Oh, Highlander.
Who wants to live forever?
Isn't that Chris Roberts?
Who wants to live forever? No, I'm talking about the one with Tarzan in it. What's his face?
Christopher Lampen?
Yeah. The one which is rumored to be getting a reboot.
Ooh.
With Henry Cavill.
Oh, Sean Connery.
Yeah, the one with Sean Connery.
Sean Connery, who pretends to be Spanish.
Anything with Henry Cavill, I'm very interested in.
That's interesting.
He'll be in 40K as well. So,
I knew that. But I didn't know about the Highlander. Look forward to that.
Yeah, it's a great movie. The original was a great movie. The TV series was meh.
it's a series.
So I'm curious to see if they do a remake, and if they do, and if Henry Cavill's in it. It'd be interesting. I did like the whole premise behind it.
Yeah, but there won't be any Clancy Brown. Clancy Brown was excellent in it. I loved it.
Oh, yeah. Well, you never know.
maybe coming
He's still
out,
around.
He's still around. So is Christopher Lambert, so...
So he could make a cameo. He could be in there, you know.
Yeah. Put in CGI Sean Connery, you know. You never know.
No, we don't need Sean Connery now. Anyway, I guess we should actually talk about the game.
Game? Okay.
Not a game. Tech demo. Talk about the tech
demo.
You
want to get into a weird meta shit? Because there was someone
that
pointed out a funny fact about the dating system in Star Citizen.
Oh, yes. Yes.
But it's just one of those things that you're like,
the leap year?
You can't go that detailed because you're not... We're talking about a fictional universe here and you can't really...
Yeah, but that doesn't stop people from being stupid.
No, but I mean like
it's true, but it's a good thing to point it out, though. See, the calendar repeats every 26 years, so CIG should have... adjusted it so it does work out every 26 years or so.
No, they shouldn't have. I mean, it's a game, so you can't really get that far into detail.
Yeah.
That's the premise. But it's funny that somebody actually researches all of this. It's like these people, some people, and I say this with respect, but it's like they appear like they have no actual life and they're actually looking and trying to figure out how this works.
I wouldn't say that. It's just a bit of fun.
It's looking funny. Minutes of fame is what they're looking for.
But this is it's called Jail. He's like also one of Yale. Also one of the wiki editors. He's really good at that sort of stuff. And let me pull up the thing though. I'm trying to my browser Discord. Wow, I haven't done this in so long. How does this work? Oh, that's the backer page.
Wow.
Yeah.
Except refuse all essential cookies.
Oh wow, that happened. Fuck off.
Now you have to log in. My God.
Why am I doing it this way anyway? I should be going with the desktop. There we go. That's better.
No professional. Yes, we are.
Yeah. But it's basically he's talking about the fact that since the game is 930 years in the future, but the way that they are handling the date system is basically parallel to the current real life year, right?
Yeah.
Which he figures out as he calculates it here is actually wrong because of leap years. You can't just say, oh, 930 years in the future on this date exactly is the same day as today, because some of the years, just like today in real life, this year in real life, 2024, is a leap year. In 2954, it won't be a leap year, assuming that you keep the exact same dating system and just calculate it ahead as it is today. It may not be. I mean, that's just the thing. Within 900 years, stuff may change. But, yeah.
Yeah, so basically...
there's also leap seconds and leap whatever. It's just interesting and funny, but it's like...
Did he take into account that the world is rotating faster and so that we're actually... Our time is not...
Actually, it's
our clocks are not right, and so we don't know what it's going to be like in 900 years. That leap year thing may have worked its way out because we're rotating faster than what we were
in 900 years. That's in galactic standards. That's like a blink of an eye. 900 years in universal timeline. 1,000 years.
We might even adopt a new what do you call it?
New calendar,
yeah. a new type of calendar, because we're you know, a multi-planeted system.
So
a race or whatever.
When next time someone says, "Star Citizen is 930 years in the future," but instead you say, "It's 930 years and 9 minutes in the future."
Time is relative, so you have to have a system that adjusts for the space time.
Well, look, we've only been around for what, a couple thousand years. In civilization, humanity. And we've already added at least 2 months to the calendar. So in 900 more years, they're going to add more months to the calendar. People are going to get pissed. So they started adding minutes instead. The first galactic emperor is going to add a galactic minute to honor him to the calendar.
How do we're not using the Terra calendar now instead of Earth calendar?
Because Earth's still the capital, you fucking traitor.
I might be a Terran supporter. Who knows?
One of them.
This definition will continue to drift every 1 second every 19 months and will cease to be accurate in 2100. When the real world calendar will skip a leap day, but the law calendar won't skip the equivalent leap day in 2070. God, this is, yeah. And it's, yeah. So the thing is too, of when you count these leap days, every time there's a leap day in the real world year and not in the Star Citizen year, it'll be off, and then it'll be back together in the next leap year. And it's just, you get situations just like when you realize time zones don't shift into daylight savings everywhere in the world at the same time. Sometimes they're like 4 or 5 weeks apart. Which means that in between those weeks there's like a time period where the difference between Europe and America is actually bigger or shorter in hours than it is normally, and it's such a stupid system. And I'm like,
yep,
I bet you this he can calculate all of it, but I bet you like in 100 or maybe 200 years in real life, someone will have made adaptations to the time measurement system already.
We should go back to sundials and make everything relative.
Well,
So you, wherever you're standing, you look at the clock. It tells you what time it is.
This is actually an interesting subject anyway, when you're interested in that sort of history, because historically, the time measurement system in the last 2,000 years has already changed so many times that historically some of the dates that occurred in some of the years, they never occurred because the dating system suddenly changed. That meant that a couple of months had suddenly been passed because, you know, it wasn't synced or something. It's the same thing with some of the Caesarian periods with the Romans, that a couple of months of time is suddenly gone because historically it doesn't match. So how do you measure that in the current model? When people write something down, they document what date it is, but realizing that the dating system changed over time, that is not the same day in the current time standard, you know, that sort of stuff. It's getting really complicated at that point. It's just, you have to be...
Time is overrated.
That's why you have to be a genius like Einstein to understand space-time.
In the future, we will base our time off of the galactic core or something.
That sounds like a plan to me.
No, it's too close. You have to go by quasars that are so far away. You have to go by quasars that are billions of light years away.
And double neutron stars.
That's the only thing you can accurately do because they're so far away that they will not move. But don't forget, we also orbit the Milky Way, so there's far too many variables. And again, back to time is relative to gravity. So if you go near a star that's much denser, time will be slower. So,
yeah, but that's relatively...
You know? Yeah.
It just shows you that in physics, time is just another dimension and it can be warped just like any other space.
And just like any other illusion.
Just like any of the other three dimensions in space can be warped and rippled and whatnot.
I genuinely find this whole thing fascinating because we truly don't understand what reality actually is. It doesn't exist.
We're a simulation.
We're holographic. Well, so we're two-dimensional. We're three-dimensional projection of a two-dimensional plane. That was the latest theory.
Yeah, and the four-dimensional beings.
No, we're four-dimensional beings. If only we can get outside of time.
Don't perceive the fourth dimension in the way we
just because we don't
dimensions.
Perceive it doesn't mean we don't live in it.
Yeah, we act on the dimension of time.
Yeah, we can't manipulate it like the other three dimensions.
We can manipulate it for ourselves.
But it's always linear.
Because we haven't learned how. Linear. Because we haven't learned how to manipulate it properly.
All this for a game.
I don't think we can, yep. though.
We can. Scientists are already finding out that we can actually...
It's because there is no game. So we have to talk about this shit.
Maybe exactly. Star Citizen is in the fourth dimension. Maybe that's the key.
So what if in Star Citizen...
Actually, we are in Star Citizen. We are the NPCs.
We are the captain now.
What if you head into one of those systems that has a black hole in it and then go really close to it? Technically,
time will be slower and going near it would be troublesome for you. But it's not just a black hole. Again, a far more denser star would cause issues.
How? Just being near Earth has issues. If you know that they have atomic clocks.
Yeah, no, I know it's, and I have to keep adjusting it.
The atomic clocks are synchronized on Earth, and they take one and they move it up into atmosphere, not even into space. They just put it on a freaking plane, and the clocks become unsynchronized because of the gravitational effect of time. Right, but
you can't then resync them, right? You can't speed it up. We can only go slower. We can't go faster.
Yeah, it's at the bottom. No. Go up down to the end.
Are you looking for the black hole?
Where is he? I can't see his orientation now. Did he move this?
No.
It's near the Banu border.
Banu border. Banu border is everywhere around us.
No. He twisted it, didn't he?
Do you know what it's named?
Yeah, it's a short name, isn't it?
Baker?
No, that's the racing one. I got back.
That's a twin star, by the way.
Yeah.
Because you can just type it in.
That could actually cause issues. Oh, zoom out. I know when I see it.
Osiris? Goss?
No.
Karen? Helios?
Give me Banu system.
Tyrol? No, that's... is Banu the green stuff? I'm not even sure. That's Xion.
No, that's Xion.
No, the Banu is the... No. The triangles. Oh, okay. No. There's only one system in the Banu.
No, there's three of them. Or four.
It only shows me one. Oh, there we go. Bacchus, Geddon, Gleese.
Okay.
Gleese, right? That sounds familiar.
Yulin.
Tamshat, go back. Go right.
Tamshat.
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, can we go into it?
Okay, write that down so you don't forget it.
Yeah, you tell her
black hole, it doesn't say.
So apparently in the law, you're not allowed in this system. This is a restricted system.
There's a jump point to Banshee and one planet.
But there's only one jump point in and out, yeah.
Yeah, to Banshee.
That would be pretty bad for you if you went near that place.
They said you will die.
Well, not only do you die, but as I said, time slows down when you're near a massive object, so...
Yeah, well, I don't think they're going to be able to replicate that in the game.
Why not?
They're just going to kill you. They'll just suck you in.
I bet you mean like close, when you go back to...
You're gone.
To reality, to another system, you're suddenly... Only 10 minutes have passed since... when you've been in this Tamsa system for maybe hours. And then you go back to another system and only 10 minutes has passed. No, that's impossible anyway. Because real life time is always linear. How would they do that? How would you do that? We answer.
They'll kill you. They will just kill you. You get too close, you die. Otherwise, you're not affected by space-time.
Why am I killing you?
Maybe they'll,
get close
maybe
to
they'll
the
have
event
it.
Horizon.
Maybe they will have it.
They'll
that
suck you in.
What they could do, though... I mean, saying they want to implement something related to time dilation, the fact that closer you are to these massive gravitational objects, you move through time relatively slower than the rest.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe they could make it so that instead of, you know, you can't be desynced with the rest of the galaxy because, you know, you're still a player here sitting at your computer. Time doesn't move slower for you than it does for all the other players in this universe.
Maybe that's what they're going to be working on after server mission.
Yeah, it's an actual time dilation device for players. But what they could do maybe is like have other effects that it's like maybe you get thirsty and less quickly than you do when you're outside of this system. Like you could last a lot longer.
Here's a novel idea.
I don't know.
You get too close. You go in there, and if you get too close, it sucks you in and kills you, and then they don't
That's
have to worry
cheap.
About time dilation at all.
That's just cheap. No, because the time dilation effect is much wider than just
better,
the fact that you die.
It's better than them. Right now, not even allowing us to go to the system and having it there as a tease.
There's another planet, actually. I forgot. Wow. It's Gas Giant.
Yeah, well, people go there for fuel, then.
Huh.
No, they'll probably do a simple thing as, you know, get too close to it and your ship explodes, something like that.
Yep, they suck you in. Gone.
How big is this system? Oh, wait.
And who knows? Maybe they'll want to turn it into a rotating black hole, and basically it becomes a worm or a tunnel.
304 to another system units.
Someplace else. Fuck. So you come out.
Fuck. That's how you get to
in a quasar somewhere, and then
that's how you get to the other species on the other side.
And then you die because you explode from the heat from the quasar.
No, I like your original suggestion before you went crazy there. No, a wormhole. That's exactly it. A wormhole. Black hole this is how you get to the Katak.
Or maybe to the other uber species like the
heart of the Vanduul system to their home planet.
Yeah, maybe.
So either this...
It's a one-way trip. You ain't coming back.
This chart is being rendered relatively or something, or illustrated. In this case, it's off scale, because according to this, the outer planet or planetary orbit for Tamsa 2 is further away than the Yulin system is.
How big is it? Oh, yeah. Well...
the system is 304 astronomical units wide, but if you scroll, I just think this is not to scale. That's probably why you're looking at this like that.
No, ignore the map itself.
Because this can't be right. It can't be true that this Yulin system up here. It's like showing that it's within the inner orbit of the second planet. It's closer to the star than the second planet of the same system. That just can't occur. Obviously, it's not accurate. It's off scale, probably.
No.
It's a large system, dude.
But it's a large system anyway, so I think it'll take you forever to get across the thing.
Damn it, I keep going. I want to see the information. 30 elf AU. That's a lot shorter, smaller. Banshee 56 for 14.
So, layer considering this time, 11. 4, 300 is quite a lot.
Vanguard system.
I don't think
one...
we have anything to worry about with that planet for a while, since we only have one system.
Isn't Lear close to? Oh wait, I'm looking at. I'm confusing two systems, I think.
Well, Lear, that's one in Arena Commander.
I thought, no, the Delamar is in Nyx.
So you're looking at this upside down.
No, this is how it started for me. Upside down. What is up? What is down?
I always point... what's the name of it?
I mean, the Vandals should be to the...
left.
East?
Left.
West. To the left.
Oh, shut up.
Twist it around. Put the Vandals to the left.
Let's refresh it and see what the default mode is. No.
Just zoom straight out. Don't use them. See, you've broken it now. God damn.
No, I'm getting rid of the link, because the link gave me a camera preset. You
take the button. Now zoom straight out.
All right, now zoom out. See, it's on the left.
Vandal.
Why would I?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Vandal West.
And then Gion on the west, or east even.
On the right.
Yeah.
There is no east-west in space.
Well, there could be.
That's something that we created on Earth.
And then the Bannu on the bottom. And that's where Tamsa is, as you can see.
Mm-hmm.
So, where were you looking for? You were looking for Nyx or something?
Nyx is right next to Stanton. Stanton's more or less in the center of the map.
Yeah, there's Stanton there now. See how long it takes to find it. It's gone all the way around.
I see Stanton, but I want to see Nyx. There we go. Yeah. Where's Delamar?
So, as few of you might know, Nyx is the next one that we should be getting after Pyro.
Yeah.
We're putting the horse in the cart before the horse. We haven't gotten Pyro yet.
This is 11.
I think it's quite safe to say we'll be getting it this year.
I'm betting we're gonna, I bet we get
you get nothing.
We get Nyx not that long after Pyro. I think it's already done.
I wouldn't go that far.
Well, okay, Pyro. Maybe not, because they got to put a lot of.
But I do expect it before the end of the year.
They do have to put settlements and all that other kind of shit on the different planets, just to flesh it out a little bit.
Well, as my theory goes, it's part of Squadron, since Odin, if you go from Nyx to Odin, Odin is in Squadron.
Yeah.
But Odin's not going to look the same. They said that they have to rework it because time has passed.
A little bit, but it's not like planets will completely drift away in 10 years.
Oh, no, it's just the features they have on there.
Yeah, so assuming that they'll build out like kind of like this strip of systems, basically Stanton, Pyro, Nyx, Odin, maybe some of the surrounding ones after that.
Well, we have to have Vegas, and that's also in Squadron.
Did you actually go there?
But isn't Vega under
Vega's
Vega's
on the Vandalor end, yeah. Could be.
So this course. We know that got invaded. By
Shady, happy new year.
Hey Shady, how you keeping? Bremen is a major base for the UEE Navy, so
yeah, it's a military. Vegas. So, yeah, so it connects to Bremen,
which connects to
Bremen. Yeah.
So. Yeah, they're opening up a can of worms with this. As soon as they start opening up new systems, they're going to be like having this domino effect.
Vandal attack, wow.
And speaking of new systems, let's talk about the 3.23 and server meshing?
Server meshing?
Or is it... the replication layer. What was it that they said that they worked on that's possibly coming out in 3.23?
I'm not sure if the replication layer confirmed yet.
Something was confirmed. Kind of. I think it was in a Bar Citizen.
Uh-oh. Where are we going to find that? We need confirmation of that. Yeah, that was a few weeks ago, wasn't it?
That popped up.
Damn it. How are we going to find that?
Oh, you guys work your magic. You're good at that kind of stuff.
What was mine?
There was a Bar Citizen where a lot of stuff was semi-confirmed from the devs. 3.23 will include the first... It may include... replication layer. They're talking about the first iteration or a very base level for settlements, maybe just the back end, not necessarily actually allow us to build anything. What else did they say was coming? Some other cool shit. But yeah.
I don't remember.
And that is supposed to be Q1.
Oh, base building. That's it. The first iteration of base building. Yes. Already.
So that's supposed to be in the first quarter. That should be somewhere April.
March, April, yeah.
Well, we never hit our fucking goal. No. It's always a month later.
You never know.
So... I would say, yeah, probably April.
Though, I prefer to have the persistent hangers before then, really.
The thing about the base building, remember, they told us a lot of shit we're getting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm pretty sure the persistent hangars and the freight elevators will be part of the first quarter release.
I hope so. That's a massive quality of life improvement, having that.
I mean, I think they pretty much, you know, they're tweaking it right now.
Yeah.
Right.
I didn't realize it was that close.
I mean, they showed it to us, whether or not that was just a fake or it was actually in-game.
Oh, it was
that
fake.
They showed us. No, usually they show us this stuff as it's being done. So it looks fairly done.
Well, now, we didn't really see any of how it works. You
with,
just saw them well, appearing buildings.
There's nothing to see. You have... No, you're talking base building. I'm talking hangar.
Magic...
I'm talking persistent hangar and the freight elevator.
Yeah, because I was thinking like the thing at the end with the base building and the.
No, the base building is going to be very, very basic. If they give us anything, I think they're just going to give us the ability to buy up the plot land plots, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then maybe they'll give us the little push cart. So that we can set something up. I don't think we're going to get a whole lot of stuff that we can set up.
No, I don't think so. I think it's just a homestead, a garage, maybe.
Maybe I think it's going to look something like one of the freaking pyro settlements. It's going to be a rickety freaking, you know, shack that we can say is our home. And it has a little beacon sticking right in the ground next to it.
It'd be a space tent.
Yeah.
What a campfire. Yeah, I don't know. I don't expect it, but I really not interested in that. I want that hangar first.
Yeah, I want the hangar first too. They have to have that first before they can actually give it to us in settlements. So they got to get that shit working right before they allow us to build our own hangars and stuff like that on our property.
I've got another ball drop.
Oh, we're going there now, are we? Okay.
We kind of wing it as we go.
Yeah, all right. So I was going to say this last month because that's been out.
Wait, what's Shady saying? Let's find out.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah. He's basically agreeing with us in regards to the stuff.
Okay. I remember that. That's what they said. They start developing that. What they showed at CinemaCon was like...
That's endgame.
A quick idea. They had maybe have modeled some of the basic structures, but they need to actually start it.
Well, you got to remember, right? They already have the tech.
Yeah, probably.
They do, because that's how they're building all of these settlements. They are using that tech to build out the settlements, and then they were going to built an interface for us that allows us to build our settlements. So that what they're going to start doing is building out the interface so that we can build out our settlement, and not that kind of settlement. I'm talking about, that's what they use it to build their settlements. But what I'm saying is they're using the tech to build the settlements. They're going to create an interface for us that allows us to create our own settlements. What they also need to develop are what buildings and stuff that we can actually do, or, you know, blueprints and stuff like that. You're right, Shady. Keep it low and you'll be fine.
Absolutely spot on. Yeah. No, I always have that attitude with Star Citizen now. Because then anything that does, you know, come out is a nice surprise.
Yep.
But I do actually expect, I think, the initial base building to be something like this. It will be just a hab, garden, some power plants.
Again, they have to build that. So, A, I don't think they're working on the galaxy. I don't think they're going to be, I'm guessing, right? So that takes a long time to build, right? Mm. Same thing with the Pioneer, right? And you have to have those for the high-end settlement stuff, right? Yeah. They're going to start us off small and grow us, right? Just like they do everything else. You start with this first person tool, then you go up to this, you know, the vehicle or small ship, then you go to medium, large and stuff like that, right? So the first thing we're going to get is that little hand cart. Now, what we're going to be able to build is probably going to be looking like this part right here. You know, not a whole lot of anything.
A cargo container.
Then
Is it
the Titan chassis or the Atlas chassis or whatever the fuck they call it?
The Atlas platform. Yeah, yeah.
The Atlas platform, right? Yeah. So then that they can kind of build quickly because they already have multiple versions of that vehicle. So it's just adding a new component and incorporating the mechanisms, right? So that should allow us to build something more substantial. Maybe not like this mining thing. I think that's definitely going to have to be either the Galaxy or the Pioneer. But it might allow us to build a more robust building.
Yeah, I think the modules that makes you money will be the highest level. Anything that's just there to store you or your vehicles, then I think should be basic level. But anything beyond that, yeah, that should be for reserve for the larger vehicles.
Yep.
But I'm not sure, are they going to, like, is the living module, are they going to be all the same size? Or are they going to give us larger? See, I think that's the living module.
Who knows? It all depends on what they feel like they can do, I guess.
Yeah.
They may give us multiples. They may give us little ones. They may give us big ones. You know? There it is, right there in that picture.
Yeah, there it is, yeah, right in the middle.
The yellow thing on the back of the truck.
Zoom, enhance.
Oh, you can see it. It's not that tiny.
The only thing is, we've talked about this before, is articulated vehicles. We don't have them yet.
Yeah, well, who knows if we're ever going to have them.
An issue.
They can build spaceships. They can't build articulated vehicles. There it is, right there.
There's your little platform, yeah.
There's a little platform.
So, yeah, it depends. We'll see. I'm not hopeful for the first quarter. I know that it says, but I'm still not hopeful.
You're not a true believer.
I say first half to be safe. Land claims, yeah.
Yeah, I think land claims and maybe building out a small habitat is probably where we're going to end up.
But that's the thing, Shady. The Atlas platform gives them great scope to have a wide variation of items for it. You know, they don't need to keep developing too much.
They have to put in the effort. They have to find the time. I'm with you, Shady. And guys, I think that's great. I'd like to see a gas truck. Right? They're putting fuel connectors on all of the ships. So you have to have like a truck or something that you plug it in.
Home. ET phone home.
Thank you, everybody. Yeah.
Yeah. It could be cool, right. But as I said, I'm not really excited. Again, I'll reiterate, the hangar is more important.
Mm-hmm.
I I think we'll get the hang of first quarter.
So this thing. So our wonderful people at
Leaks.
Platform SE Leaks. So they've had a drawing of this up on their website for a good while now. And they were playing good by saying, no, we won't release it until closer to the time. And then somebody else apparently got a hold of the image and released it. So they released it then quickly after.
And I saw a lot of developers venting their frustrations about how it's not cool.
Why not?
Because they put all this work and effort into this stuff, and they want to release it in a way that people will really, you know, get that wow kind of factor and stuff. And then when they leak all of this stuff, it just takes away from it, and it's wasted effort. It's not wasted effort. I mean, but it just takes away the impact of all of the stuff that they do to get it ready for the community.
Yes, we like surprises. And so when the surprise is spoiled, yes. This is why I'm not a great fan of it. But as I said, SE Leaks did try their best. I have to give them credit for this. They did try not to totally spoil it, but somebody else apparently got their hands on it. Which is, I find that interesting. I thought this was SE Leaks' or pipeline, I should say. I thought this was their exclusive, but somehow somebody else managed to get it, which I find very strange. So the real issue here is, who's the fucker in CIG who's releasing this shit? That's the key problem here. You know, there's clearly an employee who's giving away this stuff. I don't know if CIG can be bothered to crack down on their security, but is it really worth it? But
yes. I think you don't need that kind of people in your, unless they're doing it themselves, which I don't think they're doing, because they usually, when they do it right.
Yeah.
You don't need people like that in your organization.
No, you don't. But that then requires, you have to set up, you know, internal security. You have to put time, effort, and money into it. You know, do they want to do that?
That's what their IT department is there for.
Hmm. See, they do have a lot of show and tells. That's where a lot of this stuff comes from. Because I remember when the latest cutter came out. What was it? The Rambler.
Mm-hmm.
So all the images that were leaked a few months ago of the Scout and the Rambler, that came out of a show and tell. So yeah, this is probably where most of the stuff comes out. It's usually by somebody's probably nothing to do with the ships per se, and he just saw this slideshow and he probably just managed to get a copy of it and yada yada yada. But yeah, it's concerning that this happens. It does spoil it for us, but the community doesn't care about this anymore, because, you know, they're happy when they see leaks, which is the sad reality of it.
So what do you think of the ship, though?
Let's go back to the ship. So it's an interesting one. It's by Myra, which is the offshoot of MISC. And I thought this was to do with performance vehicles only, but this seems to be an all-out heavy fighter. A two-person heavy fighter. Which is what we need, another bloody fighter. I don't know. I'm starting to get sick and tired of all these fighting ships. I really wish they went elsewhere with it. But I suppose it does make the money.
That's the name of the game, my friend. Money. It's all about the money.
So my expectation is we'll probably see this at Invictus, since that's when all the fighting ships come out, which is in May.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, that sounds reasonable.
It's also clearly one of the ships that we see in Citizen Con. One of the silhouettes.
Yep.
So I'm not sure about it really. I suppose it could be kind of cool.
It looks like a mecha that hasn't converted yet.
I suppose it does, yeah.
I'm waiting for a Robotech conversion. All of a sudden it just changes into some kind of mech.
I'm not sure if I get it though. I don't think I will. Far too many useless fighters.
I guess if it's two person, you got a turret gunner and then you got a pilot.
I don't see a turret though.
Maybe on the backside. Maybe it's kind of like running on a rail, just like on the Scorpius.
Maybe, yeah.
It may just not have been modeled yet in this picture.
Probably you're right there. Yeah. That's a good point.
Well, it looks like there's a rail running along the top of the center.
Yeah,
there.
That's what I mean. Like, yeah, there should be something there, maybe.
It's difficult. I'm not sure really what the function of this will be. Would this be a high speed heavy fighter or? I can't see the guns either.
Maybe it's a sniper. Like a railgun sniper ship.
Well, then would that not be just a single weapon, single gunship? Then that's all you need.
Well, that's kind of what I tried with the Ares, but
except they don't. Most people don't like being sniped by the Ares, so I doubt they're going to go down that path again.
Yeah, but now they do it with four guns. That if you hit all four at the same time, they do a serious amount of damage, but individually, they're not actually that powerful. Who knows? I don't know. Long range, bada boom.
A data runner. You think it's a data runner, Shady?
A what? No.
Data runner? No.
Transformers, yeah.
I mean, it could be because, what do you call it? It is a racing vehicle or by a racing manufacturer.
Is it?
Well, it's a performance manufacturer. I thought that was the whole idea. I was always surprised to see it, but
what's the difference?
I don't see any real big guns in it, so it may be just slightly heavy armored, but it'd just be quite maneuverable for the size. I don't know. Just I think that's just another money grab, really. Before you go there, we might also show the other ship.
The sneak peek.
Yeah.
What other ship?
The sneak peek. In the email. Which everybody's come to the conclusion that it is the Zeus.
No, it is a Zeus.
Really?
Yeah.
It's obvious. Yeah.
when you look at them up.
So it looks like, they're going to be done with the Zeus sooner rather than later.
I thought this was supposed to be further down the line, but it's obviously you want to get this out of the way. But yeah, that's the back end of the Zeus with the wing, you can see. There's a lot more. I was looking closely at the three different variants, and none of them have anywhere close to the amount of detail that we see here in the middle section. I'm still trying to figure out which it is. I don't think it's the MR, which is the one with the EMP, or the quantum indictor.
Also, it's clearly not dexterized or anything. This is a white box model.
Well, I was looking at the concept images, and none of them have anything as close as detailed as the center section here.
Oh.
So this is why I was contemplating, is this another variant that there might be, could be released? Because remember in Citizen Con, they actually showed a fourth variant called the ST, meaning...
Oh, yes.
It was status. Now, I was looking closer, and again, the middle section didn't match up with this. This doesn't match up with any of them. But I'm also going to throw the possibility that this could be the fourth variant, and they might be releasing that later. But it makes more sense if this is the ES, the basic model, just to get that out of the way, and therefore help to flush out the RSI. What's the word for it? Design,
design language.
Yeah, so remember they were talking about training in new people and getting mm-hmm. them up to speed, and they were using the RSI as a way.
That's one way to do it.
Yeah, so they could be rushing the Zeus just to get people up to speed, so therefore they can tackle the larger ships better, or quicker, more efficiently. So that would make sense. So it's definitely not that one. Cool. See in the middle there, you don't have that kind of long striped section in the middle. But yeah, it would make sense if they did that. That'd be more logical.
Where's this ST you were talking about?
The ST. So we see one image here. There we go. So the Zeus status. So I believe this.
Oh, that's right. That one picture. Yeah. I could have where I thought the ship was just a different skin.
So this is possibly a luxurious version, similar to like the Phoenix is for the Constellation. But again, the middle section looks different there, so it's difficult to. But again, usually when they're gray box and a white box, and they can flush out the design to make it look different. But this one has an extra wing at the top that folds in on the sides, so I'm not sure if that's it or not. But yeah, so they showed it on white boxing.
This is not the same model.
But at the white box model, so that's always very basic.
Yeah, so they're in the gray box. Because they have more detail.
I'm not sure. I thought that was
white box. Is it gray box first and then white box?
No, I thought white box is first and then gray box.
Right. Yeah, so that's white box.
Yeah.
Because that's very low detail. The sneak peek is much more detailed, so I would say that's a gray box.
Okay. Yeah, so we could be seeing that sooner than we think, hopefully. Fingers crossed.
I hope so, because I have a funny feeling that will be my main driver. That's a smexy ship.
So now we can talk about 5 million.
And people are like, why doesn't it look like the original Zeus?
Yeah, let's worry about that drama later.
I didn't realize this happened.
Backers. Five million
accounts. I wouldn't say backers.
Yeah. So again,
I can tell you that I dropped because of my number of accounts, it's just over 5 million.
Why? So half of these 5 million are yours, are they?
No, I have 4 accounts.
4 million? Wow, okay.
No, I have four. Four. Just four. No zeros behind. Just no four. Zero.
This popped up last week, I think. It really isn't a big deal because, as we said, their accounts doesn't mean they're, backers or anything like that. And I'm not sure, do these actually include paid accounts?
Has anybody Yeah, that's true. I mean, there are a lot of accounts that people haven't purchased anything yet because they're waiting for the game to come out and they just do free fly.
Yeah.
But I would say, you know, I would say we probably are at least at 4 actual unique.
Well, I think Roberts actually released some of that information in a letter a couple of years ago. Someone quoted this here actually, and in December, that says 12/30/2022. So that's the 12th day of the 30th month in 2022. Whatever. This says this. So it quotes Chris Roberts because he had it in a letter. This year, over 1 million unique players logged into Star Citizen and played our game. And they did it for more than 46 million hours total. Daily active users has grown 50% over last year. So that was in 2022. Probably more last year. And then, I don't know. So at least 1 million unique players logged in into 2022. Right.
I'm pretty sure that they have at least 4 million unique players.
That's difficult to measure, though. But, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, it is. Then, I mean, unless they can, but they're not going to tell us.
How can they? So they know, did they know you have 4 accounts exactly?
Yeah.
Well, he's 4. I have 3.
I'm a data guy. I can tell you. They can tell you.
They can tell the same thing for all the other people that have multiple accounts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How?
Because there's information that they collect that will distinguish everybody.
A shared same IP, I think, would be one of them anyway.
Well,
that doesn't make sense either.
But that doesn't necessarily. But they
family owners can have
credit cards. Credit cards, yeah. Right? The way you pay for it.
That doesn't exclusively
your actual address,
the same.
Your name, yeah. And stuff like that. Let me put it this way. They have a much better understanding of how many unique players they have than...
Well, you could measure it ballpark, but you can never know exactly how many actual unique people...
No, you're right. You're right, but they can come pretty close. But
yeah, probably, yeah.
Well, it's probably better off doing it this way as we're looking at it, because it hypes it up better, you know? So, let's say there's 5 million interested people.
Oh, we know there's a lot more than 5 million interested people.
Ah, yeah.
They're all just waiting.
They're just waiting, exactly. Even the ones you calling it a scam. Yep. Which brings us nicely to the Legatus pack. Shall we talk about that?
It's just, sure. God. Go ahead.
Well, we have to get salty at some time. Come on, let's get in there.
Because we're not salty, we're not angry, we're just disappointed.
We understand it. It's it's clickbait.
My God, these news outlets have nothing better to do.
$48,000. That's more than the average
imagine
person in the UK
someone at the office there was like, oh, guys, we can make another Star Citizen article again, just like last time. We'll just make an article based on the insane package deals.
They can do it every year.
We've done this before, but
it
doesn't matter. People don't care. Just make it. It'll get clicks. Yay! Do it.
It goes up every year because they add more ships to it. The part they probably didn't put in the article, which they never do, is that it's meant more for people who have so many ships. And they just want to consolidate it all into one package. That's why they do that.
Well, they see these as outrageous prices for some digital goods that some games have been offering, which is I don't think has ever been this high, which is probably true. But when you compare it to just other hobbies, there's always people that are willing to pay a shit ton of money just even for charity to donate it or to donate to a good project that they feel like is worth their money. And by way of doing that, they can get something in return, which is like this giant pledge package for $48,000. If you want it, mm-hmm. you can have it. If you have that amount of money to throw into this project, who are these people that are then complaining about the fact that these are so expensive? It's not like with any other hobby or any other subject, there's always people that are willing to throw a shit ton of money at it.
See,
I mean, people buy actual boats for pleasure sailing at sea. That's just a weird random example, but it's
hoping the orcas won't get them.
Interesting you brought that up, actually.
That's why it's not visible for a starting backer anyway, because there's no point for them to see it, and it only serves as a weird message when beginning backers see that. So that's why they can't even see it to begin with.
See, we truly don't understand people who genuinely are wealthy, how 48,000 is absolutely nothing to them. Not even remotely close. To all of us here, it's a lot of money and we would very nicely take it. But if you are rich, it's nothing to them. Absolutely nothing.
Can't even buy a Tesla with that.
If you want it, why not give it to them? But of course, as everything to do with these so-called journalistic gaming websites, it's all about clicks, as Shady says. It's an old tactic that we've been seeing since good old Gamergate, where they always exaggerate things and have no moral scruples regarding basic journalism. Mm-hmm. Only a handful of people avail of this. And CIG, as the good company that they are, obliges, because there's been a few people saying, yes, can we have a packet that allows us to consolidate all of our backings into one big
packet? We forget that in the beginning, people were actually asking for that, weren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Some people had a lot of disposable income, were like, can we donate more money to this?
Yeah.
They're like, oh, yeah, so, sure, just give you a Legatus package, $48,000, there you go.
There are some people like Trade. Is he there? Damn, he's quiet. Who just do well and earn a nice bit. So why not? It's their money. Why can't they dispose of it in a manner that they see fit? It's getting annoying now. It's a yearly thing that these so-called sites. Oh, there he goes.
They heard me. He's like, damn, he called me out on it, fucker.
Mustn't know who we are.
But yeah, it's an annual celebration from the so-called gaming websites that let's do a hit piece, because Star Citizen backers rage every time they see this, and they go to those websites and give them their clicks, yada yada yada.
Yep.
Supposedly they were like, when was the last time we did a Star Citizen article on these insane patch prizes? We haven't done it in 3 years. Let's do one again. Good for the clickbaits.
I was looking at the pack there, because somebody in the wiki wanted to set up a page about it, and I did one of those fleet views of it, of the entire all the ships and stuff. Wow.
Is it everything?
No, not everything. So you don't
really?
Get things, no, you don't. So you don't get things like the Mustang Amiga or the Raber Sabin. There are
those are unique. Yeah.
Did you say Raber Sabin?
No, you don't get any of them. So you don't get everything, which I find hilarious. You don't get the Star Kitten stuff. Again, I thought that was hilarious to see. So. They give away
all that shit to everybody else for fuckers.
You do get things like the Scythe. You do get the Idris M.
So they give them those, but they won't give them a freaking Hello Kitty?
No.
The fuck?
I'd be pitching a bitch about that. I won't give you this much money. I want air thing.
Yes. But you do get a lot of stuff. You do get old stuff, like I think you get the towel and other things that we're talking about last time.
Innovus, let me interrupt. Let me ask you this question, since we're watching this clip What was your first impression of this when I showed the Star Engine while you were sitting in the room?
So I liked it. I thought they focused too much on the clouds shit. I was like, all right, enough with the fucking clouds.
Yeah, but don't forget, this was also Sideswipe at Starfield.
Yeah, whatever. I don't care. It just, there was too much focus on the clouds and saying that we can do this with the clouds, that with the clouds, and everything else.
Yeah, yeah.
I was surprised to see NPCs. I go, oh, that's going to go badly. I was waiting to see T-poses all over the place, but then the guys walking around in the fire kind of made that
made that clear. Yeah,
yeah, that made it even clearer. Yeah,
like a nonchalant troll.
But being that I've lived through all of this stuff,
it we really knew most didn't of this was possible, but it's nice. Me. Yeah, exactly.
And it was nice. It was nice to see it all in one presentation, yeah, all one single thing.
Yeah, because now we can show it off.
Yeah, but it really didn't. It really didn't do anything for me, because, again, I've lived through the development of all this stuff, and I was like, okay, well, this is cool.
Yeah. I mean, it pretty much had the same feeling.
I did like when they showed the whales, though, and they showed the cows. Yeah. I was like, okay, cool.
Yeah, I'm like, when are we going to get this?
But for me, I thought, oh my God, they're actually going to promote the engine, as in, you know, give out licenses to other people, other companies. That's what I thought.
That's still up in the air. I mean, I think what they really wanted to showcase was...
Come on, you know they're going to do that. Come on.
Oh, I think they'd be stupid if they don't. Right?
Yeah.
But I think what they wanted to do is they just wanted to show everybody, this is everything that we have accomplished. Because... you know, it's been a while, you know, people have been complaining about where is all this stuff, right? You keep showing us all these things, but we never see them kind of stuff. Right. So, it was good for them to present this, to show everything that they've done. And obviously I forgot about the stuff at the end where they were showing us all the new tech, right? The inflections in the water, the blowing up of the destructible objects and all that other stuff. So they actually showed us new tech. That's the stuff that I really appreciated. But just the flying around and stuff like that, I didn't really so much.
God damn it. See, we have to be careful here. This is the revised version now that we're looking at. And we're not. This is definitely a better one than the original one.
I'm looking forward to the new worm, the new jump point, travel.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm looking forward to that, especially the part where you now actually have to kind of hold on.
Yeah, yeah.
Onto the controls a little bit longer, otherwise you get dropped out.
I like that actually, because it's far too simple. Really, hold B and you know you can now go off to the toilet and do whatever you want and leave it to its, you know. So I like the fact that you still have to have some form of gameplay just to even do quantum travel. I do like that idea. But I remember in the original one, the NPCs were very glitchy.
And I mean, I wasn't surprised. I was like, okay, yeah, that's live. That's real Star Citizen.
But there were weird changes. Like, for example, the guy was naked. He didn't have any jacket on him in the original one.
He was topless.
You could see a lot more of the tattoos on his back.
Someone obviously complained about it.
He's in space. It should be cold. He needs a jacket to keep him warm. By the way, that was the Renegade's jacket that you got free with your Rangers tier. If you bought that at the time. Even this was done. So here we go. Here was the NPCs running into the, but yeah, they dramatically improved that. But I thought that was funny at the time.
Yeah, it doesn't look like they're gonna survive anyway. Changing them around. The one guy that walked into the fire during the first one was probably saying, "We're all fucked anyway. I'm just gonna go end it right now." It's like, I've seen enough of these places. The ship crashed all over the Stanton system and stuff, so I know that our chances of survival are pitiful, and it'll turn into an eventual camp for the Ninetales.
This part here, I was sad that the guy wasn't waving anymore.
I saw that. It's like, you can't get it perfect, CIG. You never can. You never will.
It isn't gone.
Yeah. But do we look forward to Pyro? Pyro really is. Well, hopefully they will fix that sun flares, because that was rather annoying.
I jumped into it while I was there at CitizenCon, and I was like, okay, it's just Star Citizen with different locations and different, assets and stuff. It's still Star Citizen, nothing different. So, I mean, I'm not like super hyped about it or anything like that. It's, it would be nice to go to some of the new places and stuff, but I also know I'm going to have to deal with a lot more griefing. I'm not sure if, I'm really interested in going to Pyro.
I thought that was interesting that they didn't show the blood.
Like you said, YouTube probably.
I might probably complain.
It's probably one of those things where they have to, like, we can't have blood, we can't show blood, we can't show, topless men, because we won't get monetized and we'll get black whatever.
I don't think they care about YouTube monetization, though.
Hey, money's money.
The
amount of videos that they put out there, they should do it, because it's money that helps towards production. Income is income.
No, that's a subscriber money. It's supposed to fund the content.
Yeah, but we have many people that have stopped subscribing because they say that they're taking too long to finish the game. I believe some of you have done that. I know.
Trade would be,
Trade, Chantal. I think Realm, you only subscribe when they give you something cool, right?
No,
you don't have it continuous, or do you?
No, but that's just because I never
subscriber.
I never do continuous subscriptions to begin with. I just pay for a year and then.
Oh, okay.
I'll wait until it ends and I'll redo it if I want to, and if I don't.
Did you get the discount for the Christmas discount?
I don't think I forgot about that.
Seriously? I think that's still going, as far as I know. I think today is the last day. It finishes tomorrow at 1800 UTC. By the way, that also a reminder to go to the event calendar and claim all your stuff for your account and all your other accounts.
Claim it before you lose it.
Yeah, because there's a couple of nice guns in there and a weapon. So
the double sniper gun, that's pretty cool. I like that one.
Some of the coloring are questionable, but hey, sit around.
Those are more for display than anything else, because I'm not running around with a Christmas-colored fucking gun.
But if you are interested in subscribing, they are offering a nice discount, I think, at the moment, for yearly subscribers. That's what I usually do. I think it's worth getting. I do it to pledge for the game. I don't really go for the stuff. It's just another
liar. Liar, you want the stuff so you can take pictures. Liar.
The stuff is just a bonus, that's all. Yeah. I wonder what they're going to give away this year. Cookie jars.
Already got them.
Cookie jars of different colors.
Reskins of existing cookie jars, yeah.
Yeah. Realm, yesterday I only realized that there was cookie jars in the game. Already.
I don't look at everything.
How can you not miss it? The minute you wake up in the kitchen, there's a cookie jar.
I woke up, I run out. I woke up and I stole a plate and a magazine.
Magazine.
So you can wake up in one of the habs, and there's a plate and a magazine, and you can loot them. And I did. Because if I have a place to put them, like a persistent hanger, I will.
Well, as I said before, I did grab all of them, including even the squeezy kitchen cleaner thing.
Squeezy kitchen
cleaner. For that very reason, so I can display everything in the persistent hangers. And I will. I'll have a shelf of all the other useless stuff that the universe provides.
Mm-hmm.
There's stuff in some of the ships too that you can grab that are unique. Right, you see the wine flask from the Corsair?
Yeah, in the kitchen. Yeah. Yep.
Need to take that out of there and put that away.
I hope you can refill that. That's the only thing I look forward to that.
Got it.
It's something interesting happened to me there a couple of days ago. So I'm starting to reclaim all my really old stuff. So I have some really old Aurora skins and a few trophies that I want to get back. And as I started to reclaim them, one disappeared from my cart and disappeared from my account altogether.
Oops.
Yeah, what? So I had to send a report to concierge about that one. Luckily, I was in the CCU game app, and so I had a copy of...
You could prove that you had it.
Yeah, prove I had it, and gave the pledge number and all that. But yeah, it just disappeared out of the cart and vanished out of my account. And I went, what? You know, there's no sign of it whatsoever.
What was it?
It was the Dread Pirate Aurora skin. These are some of the Aurora skins that you could get in the Voyager Direct store many moons ago. I think they were in the RSI store and early this year, and then they removed it. There's other ones like...
Yeah, I guess if they remove it from the... and you try to reclaim it, it doesn't recognize it. That's probably what happened. That's a database issue, for sure.
Yeah, it's a weird one. It also happened at the same moment my subscription renewed. So I wanted... did that have anything to do with it? I don't know. We'll see. But I did get a reply saying, I'm sorry, due to IAE and CitizenCon, we have a big backlog. So
they always have a backlog.
Well, it is very busy for them in those times.
Yeah, it is. It is.
With requests and CS.
But I'm patient enough, you know, I could do this anytime. So it's not urgent at all. I'll wait. But it's just a warning to people when you're doing, particularly with older buybacks, because I'm slowly going through buybacks all the time, but I haven't gone near the really old stuff that I had. And use the CCU game app or take a screenshot of your buyback before you do it, just to show that you actually had it in your account. Because if it happened to me, it will happen to others. So there's a little warning. See, DHL man is...
Who?
DHL man is going to wreck the universe again.
How?
By delivering to the wrong places.
What are you talking about?
He's DHL man. He's wearing a yellow ship with everything yellow.
Oh, you're talking about Realm being delivery to the wrong place?
One thing I thought, I only just realized this because over Christmas, even though I was quite sick, I had to take a huge backlog of images. and I was using the Christmas period to take advantage of this. And I was going to try to do the hover vehicles in space, and I realized you can't call up the hover vehicles anymore at space stations. I didn't realize that.
Oh, well, I never did do that anyway.
Well, I thought it was easier to do that. Especially at New Babbage Spaceport, which is just a mess outside of the...
yeah, that's what I was going to do, actually, but I'll see.
You're better off going, I think, to the other garage. But even that's now full of ships and people deliberately blocking the ramps.
Yeah, people just park on the ramps. That's even worse. Because you can always get parking infractions. I could be the parking police, give everybody tickets.
So this is another reason why I'm seriously looking forward to the persistent hangars. Because you won't, you know, it's so much easier just to bring out your hover vehicle in your hangar and then put it into your ship. Much better than what this annoying thing is. What's wrong? Who's sleeping?
No, I think he was emphasizing dropping bombs.
Oh, okay.
You're falling from the sky, or you're going to drop bombs is what you want to do?
No, I don't have to.
This has actually brought a horror flashback. I remember doing something very similar in my Freelancer Max, bringing all my stuff from the space station down
look
to
like
here.
Anybody's here.
Oh, okay, well, that's rare.
It is rare.
Maybe not.
That's because everybody's out making millions and millions of credits salvaging.
Yeah.
Really?
I'm not interested in that in the slightest. I know we should be testing it for a wonderful audience, but I have no interest in whatsoever.
But you know what's going to happen.
Well,
it's in the PTU too, right?
We are going to get a wipe to stabilize the economy.
No.
And people are going.
How many golden tickets?
Crazy.
My stuff.
They're going to reach. I had $500 million. You're taking it away from me, and now I have to start at zero.
Yep.
No, take my money, but don't take my stuff.
Not my golden ticket.
Actually, yeah, take all my money. Just leave the stuff.
Nope.
And my golden ticket. Yeah, leave my golden ticket.
All of it gone.
I want to put that on a virtual shelf.
It's all going away.
No, no.
Who was timed out? What? Shady, what did you do?
I mentioned something about the golden
Shady
ticket.
Shady yelled. He got...
or rather not so much links. as the ticket itself, but about what they can do with that from now on. Imagine whenever engineering comes out, components and subcomponents, and SICK can say that, we have this super duper legendary subcomponent, and you got to get it from our game devs. And of course, the moment you touch it, the whole you will light up, and everyone can see you and get to you. They're going to do that again. If they did it once, they're going to do it again.
You talk about golden ticket.
Well, whatever you call it, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah, no, it was the platinum ticket, wasn't it? Yeah.
Yes, platinum. Yeah.
Yeah, there was rumors of them doing something similar for Christmas for the F7 Mark II.
They did something else. That was bullshit. That was bullshit from the start. I think they did do something. We had to do something to get a ship or something, right? Or a skin or something.
No, it was still for the F8.
No, not for the F8.
Huh?
They did something during a holiday that was ship specific, where if you did something or got something, you would get something. And I've correlated that to the golden ticket rumor. It's just I don't remember what it was. I didn't bother to remember.
I don't know.
No.
Star Runner. I don't remember the Star Runner. What was the Star Runner? The only thing I remember the Star Runner was doing the online game thingy where you had to find remember the fugitives and the star map. That was the only thing I remember.
Spoilers, whatever.
Yeah, I remember that. That was fun.
And you got your
that was some nice skins.
You got a nice dark skin.
I'm very proud of that skin.
Pity they didn't keep the texturing. The duck skin? Oh, yeah, no, it's the same skin, yeah. The I think it's called the Night Runner skin, I think, isn't it?
Oh, God.
That's it, Renan crashed into.
It's so glidey forward.
Hey, Kemi.
Need a remote. So I can open the
this
door.
This is where a remote control will be handy. If you can go into your Mobi glass and have the ability to open your back door. Now watch that vehicle go widely off into a different direction.
No, it's fine.
See? You didn't turn it off.
No.
That's always a risk.
Because I'm going to get back on right away.
So, CIG UK released their annual official report of their earnings and all that stuff. It's usually done a year behind.
I wouldn't go there, Realm. You get out that side.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
You rookie.
I forgot I usually am used to the fact that there's a sidewalk on that side when I get out of my car. Why parking left is safer for you, you know? You don't get out in the middle of the street. This...
So, if we compare 2022 with 2021, income increased 30% on the previous year. Costs increased by 29%.
Coincidence.
Which is pretty convenient, yeah. Barely a profit. Salaries, game dev, and all that increased by 60%.
Wow.
And there was a big increase in cost there.
So they're not making
money. Is that
money.
US or Europe?
This would be...
So their expenses have gone up as well as their income.
Absolutely. You can tell. See, don't forget, they also have the new Manchester office and the Frankfurt office. That would have been a big sinkhole of money.
Yeah.
Those two alone. But they're long-term investments, really. And I think they got good deals in them as well, good tax breaks in that. Revenue went up 32%. Here's an interesting one. Subscriptions were up 6% to 5.3 million.
Really?
What is that?
Nice.
Between 2021 and 2022, subscriptions went up 6%.
Subs, okay.
Yeah.
Well, the thing is it could be because a lot of people stopped subscribing and they came back. They saw the light again.
Well, I think if I remember, that's when they start introducing the discounts at Christmas for the annual sub. So I wonder, did that have an effect?
Who knows?
But yeah, so that kind of goes contrary to the belief that, you know, the number of subscribers is going down. I don't believe that.
This is a garage. Why are there so many bumps in the freaking
They slow platform? People down so you don't run somebody over or cause an accident.
Oh, look at this beautiful, beautiful. Yes.
I can do it.
There we go. Oh, well done. Well done, sir.
Just squeeze the wheels up there and it'll...
That is skill. Oh, yeah.
You know what I hate about this thing, though? Because when you... So when you hit F, D. So when you hit D, you turn right. But when you hit D and hold the back button, you turn left. Well, you turn right, oriented this way. So I should do this outside. But it's kind of funny because it's really dumb how it then operates. Because when you hold D, you turn right. I drive backwards and hold D, I turn right. That's just meant like that because for player orientation, you're still turning right. But it doesn't make sense because that would mean that every time you hit the backwards button, your steering direction changes. That means that if you constantly do this, see what I'm doing right now, so I'm still steering right technically, but because every time I drive backwards, it reverses that direction, you can see this happening. So it's weird they did that.
What doesn't make sense to me is, why did you pull that vehicle out? What do you even do with that?
It's
holds big boxes.
It's the only vehicle I have with a closed canopy.
And
I don't get
for
cold.
For what?
When you drive around, you don't get cold or...
Where are you driving around that you
Anywhere.
Can't just get off of your ship?
Don't tell him what to do.
Immersion, bud.
I'm trying to understand. Why is he driving around in the middle of nowhere in the cold?
He looks like he's going to put all these vehicles in his ship and then some stupid accident will occur and he'll lose all his vehicles.
I'm assuming that this is for your picture taking. Is that why you're doing this?
I don't know. I wasn't planning it.
I'm just having fun doing random crap.
Okay.
That
I cannot argue. Yeah, however you have fun is how you have fun.
Anyway, back to a business report. So I couldn't find this, but somebody said this, right? So apparently the vast majority of revenues are from starter packs.
Yeah.
So of course
that may have been a report from years ago when they actually did say that. I do remember they actually said that at some point, maybe 5 years ago. But it may still be true. Yeah, it's.
I mean, I would think it's likely. True because every time we do new free fly, right, and you see all these new streamers. That are finding out about it, and they're doing their streams, and they have hundreds and hundreds of followers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like they're all like, "What is this? I want in."
Yeah.
The starter packs are also really popular for gifting people. So it's possible a lot of existing backers buy starter packers to gift them to others that are new to the game. That's probably also why you see them a lot. Added to that, to actual people that are new to the game, that just buy the starter packs because that's usually where you begin, though, isn't it not?
Usually, I think most of them begin free fly, and then they're like, oh, no, I want to keep playing. Then they'll buy a starter pack.
Yeah, and then they realize all the bugs and go, why did I buy this?
But then we do have streamers that like to give away stuff so that they can keep their followers.
But don't tell Orgaming that, because every time the Legatus pack article came up, they were all going, oh my God, people spend so too much money on it. They're fools. And it's all about the big money. And again, they don't seem to realize or don't want to know that the vast majority of money comes from the basic packs. So. Which is as it should be. Vega, is he here? I don't know. He's a great one for getting all the ships in game. Because you don't need to buy the ships in the real world. There's no need to. Oh, you only do that if you want to back the project.
Especially with the way the economy is so unbalanced right now, you can get just about every ship, no problem.
Yeah, it's no, that's too low, Realm. Move your ship again. You're gonna break your door.
He's got plenty of ships to replace it with.
Almost looks like it moved to begin with.
Well, you could have broken it.
So. I think you should get a running, you know, running start.
He's not going to get up.
Get some speed going. You'll hit it. You'll do a flip into the doorway.
The mule. Angle
the tire no, into the.
No, it won't work. The mule is a bigger tire. That's how you got up.
Yeah.
Over. Just get in there, move the ship. I guarantee you now you won't be able to close the door. But yeah, so I'm glad to see that that was confirmed. A significantly smaller fraction of the revenue came from pledges for concept ships, which I find strange. I would have
people like all what the they whales. Make.
All the whales buy the concept ships.
Yeah, that's true. I can confirm that.
Except you.
Well, maybe also the fact that everybody realizes that a lot of the older ships tend to be broken in the game to begin with anyway, and it's usually only the newer ships that act properly in terms of basic functionality, the doors working. Them being combat balanced in a way that you can actually do something with it.
Close and open the door.
Because I realized recently that trying to do combat in a freelancer miss is just ridiculously stupid. Because for some reason, the enemy ships just shoot straight through the shield or something. I'm not sure what's happening, but the shield is depleting like really fast. When I fight the same ships with a fighter or a saber or another ship that is more recently working, I can get the same amount of performance. And the freelancer's size two components, it should be way better at that. It just didn't work. So it was really weird. And it's probably not the only ship that has that issues like that. Why is my engines on?
It's still too small. You should have closed the door and opened it again.
No, that functionality doesn't work. You're talking about that the ramp would open further.
Yeah.
No, it's always a set distance.
But they promised us. They showed
they
us.
They did. Actually, where the hell is that feature?
They did, but it's not in yet.
But.
Dynamic ramp.
What do you want? You want a homestead, or do you want a ramp that works?
I want a fully working game that I was promised back in 2012.
It wasn't coming out till 2016, so you still got to wait.
Oh, shit.
Where's my time machine? Salaries and related costs went up 9.5% to 56 million. 66 billion. A million, yeah. Get my numbers right. So that'll be salaries, pensions, insurance, I'm guessing, all that stuff. That's a lot now. That's a proper company when you're
yep.
That high.
Meep, meep.
Let's see. Other overhead costs, 18 million, up 56%. Contracted game developer costs, 10 million, up 24%. I wonder who that is.
Hiring contractors
outside, so like
contractors,
yeah. So the only ones I would know offhand would be the face capture and all that stuff.
No, contractors could be, you know, they needed someone to work on something, so they hired somebody to just work on one thing. Sometimes they'll hire contractors to do the concept. Hey, I need a new ship. Can you design a ship for me? So they'll pay someone to design a ship.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Let's see. Publishing, community events, marketing, just under 30 million, up 17.5. That's no surprise there at all. I can see that doubling in the next year or two, easily.
Hopefully they'll have success with Squadron 42, and that will give them a huge bucket to offset.
Yeah. Well, that'd be nice capital to have, and then you can just go to the bank and give me a loan, and they'll say yes, happily. Let's see. General and admin, 1.4, which is down 3.2%. With total costs totaling 129.4 million, up 29%. So
the only thing I get out of this report is that they're spending a lot of money to build the game. That's all I get. And it's like, yeah, that's not unexpected.
Yeah, it's exponentially, the more people there are, the higher the costs.
Yeah, I mean, I don't see what difference it makes in the grand scheme of things.
No, well, I'm interested in this because I'd like to see it run as a proper business. And so when you see everything running smoothly in that department, then, you know, that's a healthy thing. The company needs to be healthy first and foremost. And so when you see warning signs, then, you know, we should be worried about it. But, you know, right now it's running smoothly. It's the worst example of a scam you'll ever find in the history of scams.
Yep.
Holy crap, what's with the frame rate?
Get a better computer.
Again?
It's a tech demo.
I have this issue, right? And what I do is
that's back.
Change Windows. Oh, yeah. You see, it always fixes itself after a while. It seems to go to 10 or 20 seconds of this stuttering. And I usually change Windows, and then it seems to come back after a very short time.
You're also streaming the show, too. I'm sure that's
stable. Yeah, but mostly. And then suddenly there's like a giant frame rate drop is clearly not related to streaming. Or at least not likely. I'm running 60 frames right now. It's no problem. It shouldn't be a problem.
As I said before in the previous show, I'm certain it's to do with elements that are missing from the build that didn't make it in time. I remember we talked about this before.
Oh.
Remember, like the replication layer and all that stuff.
Yeah, but I don't listen to you.
Okay. That's
yeah, no, it is no telling.
Back to my corner here.
There's no telling what it could be, but again, just because it's not incorporated, I don't think it really makes it's impacting it in its performance.
So I'll skip a few things. They have 18% more people than the previous year, so I think that's gone up again. But one thing you have to do in the report is give an indication of what the following year will be. So this is what they said about 2023. With significant costs of dedication resources to Squadron 42 at the expense of Star Citizen, which is kind of obvious. So yeah, Squadron is ruining the game for Star Citizen. If you can put it that way.
Oh, they admitted it?
Well, yeah, they have to admit it. They have to give you an accurate prediction of what the following year is going to be.
Because we've been saying that forever. it's like,
I don't know. It's so obvious. It's you know, if you're not even honest with yourself, you know, that will be a thing. You really do like this spot, don't you?
Well, it is that same.
Yeah, that little hill there in the middle of nowhere. I suppose it is a nice surface. What else was there? They talked about acquisition of Turbulent, so that would be an extra 200. That will be. They expect their workforce worldwide to be over on 1,100 people.
Nice.
An expensive year, but record-breaking end of year, which is true. They did actually make more money in 2023 than 2022. against early expectations, because it was quite slow to start off money-wise. It probably didn't take till, I think, September or October before they start signs of even catching up on 2022 compared to 2023. And then the IAE event did really well for them. I think that was the most successful one, I do believe. Even though the Invictus event didn't do that well, I think 2022 was bigger than 2023. But yeah, overall, it's very healthy looking. And that's really my main point, as I said, why I wanted to bring this up. So, what else is there?
I don't know. Was there anything else?
Well, you talked about, you know, the coming year.
Salvage gun.
Oh, the new salvage gun.
Yeah, I haven't gone near it, so I don't know anything about it really, but
it's just a rifle size version.
Is it practical?
Yeah.
Well, this guy was testing it at some point, the Foxy dude. And
he mentioned
it had the exact same salvage speed and performance as the multi-tool attachment, and that just maybe because of the fact that it's a new device and they haven't tuned it to be more powerful, but it was kind of disappointing how it was just
it had more resource.
Yeah,
material.
You can stow more in the can, but that's
I saw a guy that used it. He went and tore up his Pisces.
Tony.
He went and cleared off the stuff off of the Pisces. It showed as being damaged, and then he went back and he put it back on there, and it showed that it had been repaired. So if you like using the gun, you'll like using the rifle, mainly because it can store more. So that's really the only advantage. It's that it stores more.
Yeah, but it should be more powerful and faster. It's weird that it's not, and not right now. I feel like it's something that they need to tune with the patch anyway. That's probably the purpose of why it was in the PTU.
Much as
large canister size, 1.1K. Alpha UEC.
Well, it's cheaper than the tractor beam gun anyway.
Yeah, that's a 19K.
Yeah,
I didn't get it.
Well, the tractor beam's much more handier, really. That's an essential piece of kit, I think. But you know, I don't know. I suppose the engineers.
This will only become useful when they make repairing ships a more expensive and detailed, time-consuming aspect of the game. Because right now, I just reclaim my ship.
Yeah.
Done, right? So they have to put in a mechanism that you just don't go to the ASOP terminal and go, hey, I'm reclaiming my ship, and then I have it 15 minutes later.
Yeah,
right? And then I'll just go jump on my other ship or expedite it and get it in 5 minutes, you know? Especially when money is no big deal right now.
I remember this was obviously in the early days when they were just, you know, thinking on top of their head, but they did threaten that it could take like even weeks for certain ships,
you know,
to be fully fixed. So
but right now they're not ready, they're not at that point. They have to, before they can do that, they have to give us the mechanisms to be able to work around that.
Yep, and the economy that can dictate those
times. the economy right now, I mean, fuck it, I make so much money, I can buy whatever the fuck I want. I don't care.
Yeah, money's meaningless.
Yeah.
So I'm curious. So let's say you do what Foxyloxy here is doing, right? So he's repairing his ship. And then you go to a station and you complete the repair. Should that bring down the costs of the complete repair at the station? I wonder. Or will it still charge you the same?
To bring it back to, well, the thing is, it's going to bring it back to... It'll bring it back to full restoration. So, like, right now, you see his is all patchy. You can tell it's been patched. That will go away. It'll look like a brand new body. You know, they replaced it properly.
But it should... this should have... to give this gun a proper benefit, this should dramatically reduce the costs of a full restoration.
No, because they're probably... it's like me putting a patch job on my car and then taking it to a body shop and say, hey, I want you to go and fix this. They're going to go, well, your work is shit. It's going to be... I'm still going to charge you the same amount. I might actually charge you more because now I have to get rid of the shit that you did to do it properly. So, you know, depends on how they want to work it.
Kimmy brought up a very important point. Will they roll out Tony Z this year? Since we didn't see him last year.
I don't have a marker.
God, I hope so.
Roll him out where?
In front of the camera.
Yeah.
Nah. He's too busy trying to get the...
He ain't that busy.
Trying to get Quantum working.
I'm convinced he's an android. And so they have him stored somewhere. And so they didn't bring him out last
closet, year.
He was broken.
I mean, he's probably also involved in the whole freaking... not only is he in charge of building the economy server and how it affects all of the game servers and stuff like that and building out the economy, but he's probably now has to worry about... bringing in the settlements, the blueprints, the resources, right?
Yeah.
So the man is probably buried in so much shit that he has to get done. Yeah. He doesn't have the time to be doing this stuff.
Make the time. He'd be all right. We only want an hour of his time. Hell, we're not asking much.
We demand. Need Tony.
I would love to see Tony talk about the state of the economy and where they are in regards to Quanta and stuff and when they're going to well, we already know that it's somewhat integrated, when it's going to be better integrated.
Gonna hide your car better, Mom.
I don't know, a pile of snow here.
Yeah, I was hoping to see some kind of update in Citizen Khan about the whole Quanta system.
But I was expecting something too because they asked if we wanted to see Tony Z. So I thought that they were going to, that was a clue or a hint that they were going to bring him in. But nope.
Better yet, what we can do, since all of us are concierge, we could put in a ticket to ask a question.
Where's Tony Z? You
know? Yeah.
I think made a comment on that anyway recently.
Ask if Tony Z's or Tony Z planning to speak with us this year. And most importantly, will there be a letter from the chairman? I was expecting one last month.
What the?
That's a very good point. Yes, I knew there was something missing. Thank you. So, yeah, we didn't get a letter to the chairman.
Why do we need a letter after the bombshell they dropped at CitizenCon?
This is all
about a letter. You want it.
It's all about reassurance. It's all about calming us down, going, oh my God, God speaks. Let's listen.
I'm calm already. He gave me everything I needed to know during CitizenCon.
You'll be all right. That's you.
Rewatch CitizenCon, you're fine.
What else could he possibly tell me?
I don't know. He could, you know.
If he could repeat, I'll go so far. If he can repeat half of what he said during CitizenCon, I think people will be satisfied.
I didn't know people were not satisfied, but okay.
Modern 42 is feature complete.
I mean, it's you know, I think Wii U is on to something. It's reassurance.
It's only been 2 months. I need a letter to reassure me from months of information.
Yes, we do. Yes.
It's traditional. It's more of a tradition, really. No, I understand. Like, Innovis is right. We don't have to have it, but it would have been nice just to have an annual kind of thing going. You know, 2023 has been a great year. 2024 will be an exciting year. That kind of thing. You know.
Yeah, it could be a paragraph.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be a big long story.
Hello, backers. Thank you for another year. Bye bye,
suckers.
Thanks for the fish.
To Mexico again.
Ever to this you from year, my luxury yacht.
Yeah, but as Kimmy talks about, like, all the changes now coming up are very exciting. I think. I really do look forward to this first half.
Hell yeah, we're gonna get the really cool shit. Mm.
And as you probably, stretching we, since we do does the YouTube stuff, people are just talking about, oh, what we'll get this year by way of ships and features and whatnot. Like I said, if we get half of what they said during CitizenCon, I will be very satisfied.
Yeah, well, as they said, all that stuff was for Squadron initially, so that it was all about transferring it from Squadron to.
Exactly. Yeah.
So, I'm far more optimistic of getting most of those items than previous years. Like the Moby Glass update. My God, that'd be such a. The map. Oh my God, the map.
God, can I emphasize
how much I hate that map? It is just so unnatural. It's like somebody deliberately made it to be awkward as possible. It's just nothing
in the day. Back in the day, we all thought it was cool. It worked.
No, we didn't.
We did.
We knew that there was something. Why doesn't it do this? Why doesn't it do that?
Back in the day, it was the first map we had, so we thought it was cool because we at least had a map.
Yeah.
Now that we see what the potential is, we're all like, oh no, why are we still with this piece of shit?
How long did that take me to get the Steve here? And now with the X1, it takes me 20 seconds. With the STV, it took me 2 minutes to get to this mountain. Impressive. Anyway, carry on.
Yeah, but the thing about this is that the Steve is far more suitable for unlevel terrain, where this is a simple... because it's a pure flat surface.
We're fine. Just look at this. We're fine. No trees in the way on this planet. It's just rocks that you just glide over. Yeah. I don't know, this STV also, I thought at first it was the ice lake, but it does the same thing on any terrain. It's incredibly glidey. It's like you're driving on ice all the time, everywhere.
Well, it was supposed to be sporty-ish anyway, so...
Yeah, it's not really anymore.
No, everything's changed. Yeah, you're right there.
There's Mi Rock. The mountain... hill. Faster.
So this is what you do for fun every day? You just go to that rock and then you just race your vehicles back and forth?
We should now call this Relum's Rock. And it just goes around in
That'd
circles.
That'd be fun, actually. Good way to practice.
Why is it doing this? I'm not doing this.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I have it on cruise. It's going fast as possible with... There. Flat out. Raise up and down. It should be hitting the edge of this... white shelf. It should be turning darker up ahead. I think. Right?
Are you off to full speed?
Yeah. I don't see how fast I'm going, but I'm going.
So you're low to the ground.
Yeah.
Is it if you go up, you go slower?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it is. Yeah. So you have to hug the ground to get.
I can boost, no, but that doesn't give me any.
No, boost doesn't. That just accelerates to top speed. You still can't go over top speed with it.
How far away from my ship am I now?
So let's far see. Away that I'll despawn.
It does it again.
Rhodes. Oh, tell you, can't wait for Rhodes.
Mm-hmm. I wonder if they're going to give us the ability to make Rhodes.
Well, they said, also the ability, maybe.
Well, with that base building, they sure have to be a way to clear land at least.
Well, because I did not see any roads on any of those bases.
Well, you did, so actually.
Don't get excited.
Not on the one we could make.
Not the ones that we can make.
But no, the underground facilities, the bigger underground facilities, yes. But those are built.
Yeah, the roads, they're not roads.
The garages.
They're a ramp. They're,
well, the roads.
Well, okay, so there's a rope and within the actual...
Yeah.
Construction itself, and then as soon as you exit out, it's like it's a ramp and then dirt.
Yeah, they do have somewhat of a path in the new settlements that they placed on Microtech and other planets. So it looks like
very, very short
path. Yeah, it's I'm pretty sure that it shows you that they can do it.
Well, I think that's the way
to manipulate the terrain.
Yeah, when it comes to vehicles like the Rangers, they desperately need some kind of flattish surface with no stones whatsoever.
Oh, I don't even see the marker anymore. Uh-oh.
Seriously?
Nope.
Oh, wow.
Did you see what heading I was going? I should just go back.
Nope.
Pay attention to that. That's your job.
I think it's this way. I'm probably like 50 kilometers away because I was driving.
How does the marker disappear?
I don't.
I probably ran out of range. Marker's only good for so far.
It shouldn't be that hard. If I just go this direction until the ground turns white, and then when you hit a mountain, you should be close.
I laugh at the despawn. Wow.
No, it doesn't despawn.
You don't do that.
No, but they never do that.
Persistent entity.
This is live, not PTU. I don't know what the hell they're doing with the...
It's still a tech demo, dude. Every time you walk away from your ship, there's a chance it could despawn or go down into the planet or something. Honestly, I bet you wish you didn't have those clouds, because they're making it look like they're mountains. Well, you're back on the white, so maybe you're heading in the right direction.
Is he going to find his little island mountain?
I have a feeling it's actually that way, but...
Yeah, there's not even a compass on this thing.
Well, there is a compass. I just didn't remember which...
He wasn't paying attention.
Oh.
Going.
He's
don't know
not
which...
being a proper navigator. Okay, there's a hill thingy. What's that?
Ah, that can't be. It's too small. Oh, it's really small. Yeah. Not it. I think it's actually that way. South. Are you going to wait for me to fail?
Well, it's an interesting thing. Is it a bug or is it deliberate?
Well, it doesn't show me the ship marker that I should be seeing. It only showed me the ramp marker. Which is kind of strange to begin with.
Where's Photo Road?
No, I don't think it's even here. Oh.
Weather.
Suddenly.
Yeah, I thought you were way further out.
I was.
And the funny thing about this is he could be doing this forever because we don't know if we ship despawned or not. I think it's further out to the left. The
funny thing is I can find it easily from space. I just can't go into space with this thing. Is that a target I see on the...
Did you scan?
On the radar?
That arrow? No, that arrow was your cursor. Oh, well, what's that? Oh.
No, that's something else.
123 kilometers seems about right.
213.
213, yeah.
I don't know what is detecting. The center of the planet is like below me.
No, it's behind you.
No, it's below me.
No.
Is that number climbing or decreasing?
Turn around. You were never close to the coastline. You were out further in the middle of the lake. Turn around. Just do us a favor. Just do 360.
Now, what I think, what I'm looking for is, it's supposed to be a bay.
There's plenty of bays. Scan.
There. Oh, wait. It may just be rocks. Mineable rocks. 7 kilometers.
So, yeah, you weren't that close to the coastline.
No, but I'm using it to orient. Or a map.
Can you ping at all?
That's what I just did.
Oh, okay.
No, I wasn't looking. I think it's behind them, but anyway. So yeah, this actually kind of brings up an important point: navigation.
Yeah, pay attention where you're going.
Thank God for that. We should be able to make custom markers in that new map. I want that. Should have been implemented ages ago, by the way.
Yeah, I agree.
I think the new map will help with that. But yeah, I think this is a lost cause, to be honest with you.
No. We'll eventually find his frozen body and vehicle.
I have food with me.
It doesn't matter. You can't get off the planet unless somebody goes pick you up.
Gone again?
Or you die. Well, no, actually, you should be able to log out and it should respawn you back at the nearest...
Yeah.
That looks like your rock.
No, they all look the same.
Yeah, I thought his rock was further out.
Yeah, your rock doesn't smoke like that one does.
Yeah, he's lost. As he should be.
He's not lost. His ship is lost.
No, he is lost. He doesn't
know. He knows where he's at.
No, does he?
Yeah. He's on his ship. He's on his bike on whatever moon that is. He knows where he's at. He just doesn't know where his ship is. His ship abandoned him.
His ship despawned because he left it.
Who says ships don't have feelings?
Mm-hmm. He doesn't like me anymore. I'm going back to the station. So, as we watch Realm fail miserably, is there anything else?
That I know of, not that I can think of.
Yeah, it was
hopefully we'll have an update to the roadmap this
week. We don't normally get a proper update until the end of the month.
Because right now, there is nothing on the roadmap. Zero.
Like they usually do the end of year review, but now so we never get a proper update until like the end of January, beginning of February. So
because there is nothing on the roadmap for year 2023.
Oh. They're doing nothing.
Oh, we should post that.
You missed.
Get everybody to.
The subscriber flare. They haven't yet given them out, have they?
What was the flare?
What flare?
We don't know. Have they given them out then? Because I don't know.
I'm not aware of any flare that they're supposed to be giving us.
No, I don't have anything in my hair. Where's January's subscriber flare? Where is it?
We just started January.
Just started. It's already a week in. They usually do this within the first week. For sure.
But they're on hiatus.
Who cares? They have all this pre-planned. It's like flipping a switch. You know how that goes.
Well, they denied us.
Just gliding, gliding, riding. Should we go? I'm probably not gonna find this in time. Yeah. Oh, no, watch me just being like, yeah, I found it.
Unless you can use your VOD. I don't think we don't have VOD turned on, right?
Well, I'm recording it though, but I'd have to stop first.
You would have to, yeah. Well, we're past our time anyway.
All right, then. Tune in next week to find out, did I find my ship back or not? as of right now, I'm lost in the middle of this big-ass, like...
As you should be. And that's what that game should be like this. You should pay attention to your proper navigation instrumentation.
This will show you...
I assumed that I had the marker still visible. I should have it visible, by the way.
Now you know better.
Okay.
All right. I think that'll be it. So again, a quick reminder, get your Christmas stuff. You'll have until 8 p.m. UTC tomorrow to claim everything. Also, your last chance to get all the concept ships, like the Astera and the Cutter Rambler. What else was there? All those other new ships that came out there, I think, during Citizen Con. Nothing there now. Those concept sales are now stopping tomorrow as well. I think that's it, really. I don't know anything else.
Okay, good. And until next week.
All right. Goodbye. Hopefully, there'll be a bit more news. It's gonna be quite weak, I think.
Oh yeah. We might get a patch. Do you? That's about it.
Yeah. Check out The Base. 24/7 online radio.
Oh yeah.
Visit us at thebase.sc. They're professionals.